This is Fatima. Here let us learn the concept of ASP.NET Core Framework, newly introduced by Microsoft for web development with .NET. At the end of this complete course, you can also write an application that can perform the CRUD operations, create, read, update, and delete data operations on DB using SQL Server. ASP.NET Core Framework is used to build rich data-driven web apps, services. IoT is nothing but Internet of Things apps such as smart TV, smart speakers, and mobile backends. It is a redesign of ASP.NET 4.x. Initially launched as ASP.NET 5, but later renamed into ASP.NET Core Framework. This might be due to that this framework is completely rewritten from the scratch in order to provide wide benefits and features with some architectural changes. So it is not a continuous part of ASP.NET 4.x. This ASP.NET Core Web Framework is a brand new, high-performance, cross-platform, open-source architecture for testability and extensibility, and also previously separate MVC and Web API is unified into a single programming model. Let us see those benefits and features in detail. ASP.NET Core Framework is open source. Microsoft mainly develops license-based software and platforms. First time in Microsoft history, releases this open source cross-platform ASP.NET Core Framework. So the source code is available at this link. So we can also contribute to or download the source code from the respective repositories on GitHub. So it's a good opportunity for the development community on GitHub. ASP.NET Core Framework is designed from scratch to keep in mind to be cross-platform for both development and deployment. Let us discuss what cross-platform is from ASP.NET Core Framework point of view. The earliest versions of ASP.NET applications can be developed only on Windows platform and can be hosted only on IIS web server. But now, with this ASP.NET Core Framework, applications can be developed and run across different platforms such as Windows, Mac OS, and Linux, and can also be hosted apart from IIS on Apache, Docker, and self-hosted deployment system. So you no need to build different apps for different platforms using different frameworks. ASP.NET Core provides modularity that improves the performance of an application by introducing a new concept called middleware. This middleware is nothing but a class that can be executed in every request of the ASP.NET Core app. In the classic ASP.NET, HTTP handles and HTTP modelers were the part of the request pipeline. This ASP.NET Core Framework provide rich set of built-in middleware components that is similar to this HTTP handlers and HTTP modules, but both needs to be configured and executed in every request of an application. So it is lightweight. We can also create our own custom middleware components. If it is not clear at this moment, you will get to know what these middleware components are and how to use them on progress through this course. The most common environment in software field are development, staging, and production. We will be using non-minified JS in the development, but the same should be present in minified form in staging and production to improve the performance. And it is good if it is configurable. ASP.NET Core Framework provides us such an environment-based configuration system. Testability and extensibility. One of the most important used design patterns in real-time application is this dependency injection that improves the testability and extensibility of an application. And more importantly, this ASP.NET Core Framework provides built-in IOC containers for this dependency injection. Before the release of the ASP.NET Core Framework, the only way to get this dependency injection is by using NinGent and AutoFactor. Maintainability. You can easily test and maintain applications developed using ASP.NET Core MVC framework. This is possible because it allows you to separate different parts of your application into independent pieces, and it allows you to test them independently. The testing framework such as XUnit can be easily integrated with this framework for simulating any scenario. ASP.NET Core MVC framework is designed to be highly extensible. This means you can create an application today and can be extended to any levels in feature. Some of the key features provided by this framework gives it an extensible power. One among them is tag helpers. Let us discuss this in detail in our upcoming video. Single programming model. ASP.NET Core provides a unified programming model for developing both web apps and web APIs. Previously, MVC inherits from the controller base class and web API inherits from the web API controller base class. But now, both inherits from the controller base class and returns iAction result. This iAction result interface provides several implementations. The built-in result types such as JSON result and view action result implement the iAction result interface. So in ASP.NET Core Web API, the controller action method returns JSON result. At the same time, if it is a ASP.NET Core web application, then the return type of the controller action method is going to be view result. What the ASP.NET Core does not have in coming from ASP.NET 4.x. You will not find global.sx file, web.config file, HTTP handlers, and HTTP modules of the request pipeline, ASP.NET page lifecycle model. Prerequisites to learn ASP.NET Core. You should have the knowledge of HTML, CSS, C Sharp. It doesn't mean you need to be an expert of these three. What you need is just a basic knowledge. If you know ASP.NET MVC, it's helpful, but it's not mandatory. We are going to discuss all the required concepts required for this course. In our next video, let us discuss about the environment setup in machine for developing ASP.NET Core applications. Thank you.